I love you when you do it right there.
EA Sports. It's in the game. Someone put me out because I'm on fire. I believe it's about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave. Got a dog, bro.
Fall football weather, and we've got the roof wide open here at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in the heart of Georgia. We thought the old place was loud. Somehow this place got even louder a short time ago as the Falcons were introduced to this sellout crowd. We're set to go as the Falcons get ready to match up with the Carolina Panthers. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down. 12
at the 23-yard line.
They run with Patterson. And he'll get this one up to the 26.
Number three, the ball carrier.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and nine. Shotgun. He'll look to throw. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Brian Burns in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to fourth down. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10.
Thank you.
First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey.
Whoa! 40,
but not before picking up eight.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early, because they will pay dividends as the game progresses.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Here's Walker. He's got it complete to Thompson. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
I've been turning up in my city. I've been turning up in my city.
I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
Yeah, it was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
It's a 23 yards, the final tally.
And the Panther first down.
Walker, they'll roll him out right. Bears it out toward the corner of the end zone. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. DJ Moore, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead.
The losing streak had taken on a life of its own, and I think it infiltrates a team when you're on that much of a slide. But this group has managed to focus, come out early, and put a touchdown on the board. They look like they mean business in this one.
They do. Now the key, holding on to that attitude, because, man, that streak has been a struggle for them. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And a fair catch, single four, and taken successfully.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
They did get a look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before and realize it hasn't worked
to somewhere else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays for one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Second and six. He rifles one that's intercepted. A.J. Bouye with a pick. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
What happened? Question mark.
Cover three.
That was nice work there defensively to force in completion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10.
You don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You circle the Pro Bowl. Without a doubt, that's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
Now left side of the screen.
Oh, my gosh.
A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Looking to throw again on second down. Walker completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. After one, 7-0. Audie Sports.
Panthers 7. Falcons nothing.
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on third down.
First down, Panthers.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now a run with McCaffrey. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Christian McCaffrey with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up. Meaning, when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment. That allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they're in an early hole. First drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Hassan Reddick in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Comes up third down.
Out of the gun now on third down. And it's a short one here.
Damn, that nigga fast.
Defensively, they stop him short of the first at the 32. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. Well, the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and 3. They'll try and throw for it here. Decision to go for it doesn't pan out, and the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Operating from the gun, Walker. gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A 14-yard gain there as they look to improve this 14-point lead.
And there's a catch by Christian McCaffrey, and he plays a huge role in the passing attack. He's caught over 100 passes each of the last 2 years, so he is a defense's nightmare because how do you identify him before the snap on every play? Is he a running back? Is he a receiver? Do you guard him with a defensive back, a linebacker? Whatever you do, he tends to have the answer himself and ends up making big plays.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the gun, Walker. To the right side, and he's got more complete. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Two minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina.
Touchdown.
Christian McCaffrey with his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Panthers add on to their lead. Now Joey Sly for the point after. And it is now 21 to nothing.
Makes the score Panthers 21, Falcons nothing. Joey Sly to kick off for Carolina.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. Taken in the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
25-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
How many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they used the term complimentary football?
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by the rookie Jeremy Chin. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number 1 on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
Oh, what? No way.
Turn this into a bigger point. Their thinking is a touchdown is really what they should get from starting here. Getting 3 points at the end of this drive, that would feel disappointing.
Walker now to throw again. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down. And while I'm not big on speeches and guys jumping up and down,
and he will take it across for Panthers touchdown. Christian McCaffrey on his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
What happened today? Question mark.
He's had here.
Remember in our pregame meetings, they talked about
sipping down Perry Young.
Well, when you're scoring this many touchdowns, there's no reason to go away from it, is there? They're off to a fantastic start. They hope it continues.
Three already for him. Extra point right down the middle. And a rout is on here in this first half.
Joey Sly to kick off for Carolina.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll just take a seat and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And with still more than a minute to go in the half, time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You gotta push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He'll buy some time right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side.
Oh.
And a very good return as he'll take it all the way up to the 40-yard line. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
Good starting position for the Panthers as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Operating from the gun, Walker, looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
The
Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop them with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Another try after the first down sack.
God damn, bro.
And he goes down once more. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
Now Walker sliding out of the pocket.
Oh.
Incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. On fourth down, the Panthers call on their undrafted rookie from South Carolina, Joseph Charles, on the punt. As he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. Fielding just inside the 20. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30. Nice punt, but good work on the return to get back 11 yards. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. Space to maneuver at the 40. And he will find his man on the outside. outside. So we've come to halftime after a very
sipping Don Perignon.
To Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
Young Wei Koo to kick off right now.
The Panthers out in front, and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. Fielded in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Their own 22-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive
line
spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down.
At the 29-yard line. It's a gain of 2 yards. And it's third.
They'll try and pick it up.
What the fuck was that?
Lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. His target, it's Anderson. And he takes this thing way down into Atlanta territory. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. On first down, this is McCaffrey. This
one is about
2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
At the 3 yard line. It's a gain of 8. Brings up second and 2.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the 1.
Down just shy of the goal line. A gain of 2.
Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
On the carry. First and goal, Carolina.
On the ground, McCaffrey. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn 1 here in this third quarter. Trying to punch it in with Smith. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina.
Joey Sly.
A great play there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Panthers just continue to pour it on.
Makes this
extra point, splits the uprights. And that will extend this big lead.
Joey Sly to kick off for Carolina.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half, other teams just don't get it. These are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things work well for us, and sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. The play fake. He'll look to throw. Pass incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Give them 3 yards there on the first down pickup.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
Now a shotgun snap as he'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Able to get there and pick it. Boy, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press.
Double team, and it's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And they have the football, and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. And when I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down. Call that a very strong gain of 24. Back to throw here. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Hassan Reddick able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Forced out to his left, and that's incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Give it! Oh!
It's incomplete.
But you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those, but the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Looking deep. That's caught inside the 20. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Fourth down conversion plays. You usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. Back now here on EA Sports. And this is a blowout so far as we get set. Very one-sided affair. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
The Panthers' 19-yard line.
Second and 11. Eluding the pressure right. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right, and this is going to be incomplete. We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
Sitting
down. Team wants to get shut out, so it's hard to blame them for taking the three there.
You can't blame them one bit. It hasn't been the best.
Magic City. I'm the owner. We probably don't want.
And they're at least trying to finish out strong.
Sipping down, Perry.
Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And it is starting to appear, thankfully for them, that this is the week they're going to put it all together and end that long losing streak. They're not home yet, but in control in the fourth quarter. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
first down, Panthers.
To throw is Walker. He rifles complete, caught by Moore. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 11 yards there, just like last play. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
Another first down as they call his number again. He's got 15 yards here. Again, he'll drop to throw.
Oh my gosh.
Complete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. So line of scrimmage still at 39 on second and 10. To throw again, Walker. Flush to his right. And he whips that one incomplete there. He was looking to get that one to DJ Moore. And that'll make it third down.
Up a man that time, they end up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely, just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. The Panthers on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 10. Back to throw again. Into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th. Now Walker throwing on 4th down. Open man is Anderson. And he'll get this one down about the 20-yard line. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. This is caught. And the Panthers are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last 2 plays. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. Walker from the gun, he'll throw. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because this certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You could see them sag on their sideline. And I think this one might just be over.
Field on the return. The Falcons take over first and 10. At their own
about set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. This one certainly has not gone according to script. You would have thought on paper that this offense would have its way here, but they... And now here's another interception. Picked off by the rookie Jeremy Chinn. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick 6 for a Panther touchdown.
Lining up for the point after.
That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them into the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Made at the 25-yard line. The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
After the pick 6, they go right back to the air. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
I'll tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
Yeah, once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Quan Williams. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. Defensively, they've been their way in this one. That pick six makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You're ready to go to the bench and hang out. And he said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. I might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
The Falcons take over first and 10.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And this game went off the rails early for them and never really got back on track. And these fans, they were expecting to be on the other side of the scoreboard. But that is not the case as we play on here in this fourth quarter. The throw right side is complete here on the first play of the drive. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run. Throw now on first down. Steps away to it. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Brian Burns picks up his second sack of the afternoon. After the sack, well, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got in as he threw it. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Despite a pickup of 16, they're still well short of the sticks on fourth. The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on fourth and 10. Try it here. He's back to throw. He dumps this off underneath. Here's Davis. And he's not able to get away. He is stopped well and well short of a first down. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
To throw is Walker. Off play action. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now whistles, flag down, and I believe one of the Panthers got moving early. The false start backs him up 5, first and 15. Off the play fake, Walker.
God damn.
This is caught inside the 15. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. Turtles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking.
Hey, Siri, they think they can open Facebook Messenger.
And
carry it
with them. As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Carolina, it took a while, but they finally get that first win after 4 straight losses. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Chicago Bears. Meanwhile, for the Falcons, the loss will move them back to 3-2 on the year. And they'll be off to Minneapolis next week for a look at new U.S. Bank Stadium and a date with the Vikings.
And you suck.
That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.